Assalamu alaikum to all of you. I'm Umar Qureshi from Dr. Sirajul Islam Medical College and I'm in the fourth year. I'm the team member of the MediMart. MediMart is a medical platform for the medical students. We are trying to give some short videos on some topics related to the first year, second year, third year, fourth year and fifth year. So our today's topic is basically depends on the or basically related to the basics of the heart, and it is the second video because we already shared one video related to the basics of the heart. Okay, so today we will just discuss the apex of the heart, and our reference book is Ek Datta. So you can see we have inserted a page of Ek Datta on the right hand side. So there are basically three paragraphs over given here. So today we will just discuss the above two paragraphs, because if we will discuss all of these in one video, it will be a very lengthy video. So we will just discuss the two paragraphs, the above paragraphs. Okay, so let's start by seeing over it. Okay, so what Ek Datta is trying to say, that apex, it is a conical area. First of all, we will see what is apex. We already showed apex in our previous video, so this is the apex. Okay, so what Ek Datta is saying, that it is a conical area formed only by the left ventricle. So as we all know that the heart is a conical in shape, so that's why it is a conical area. Then the second point is formed only by the left ventricle. So as we all know that heart consists of basically two ventricles, the right ventricle and the left ventricle. Okay, so this is the right ventricle and this is the left ventricle. Okay, so the apex, basically it is only formed by the left ventricle. This is the important point. You have to remember this thing, that the apex is mainly formed by the left ventricle. Okay, it does not consist of any right ventricle or the atrium, nothing. It is just formed by the left ventricle. Then the next point is, it is directed downwards, forwards. Okay, so how we can see the heart just like this. Okay, so as we all know, or as we can see, that it is in the downward direction. We can see that it is in a downward direction. Then how it is in forward direction? So the heart is oblique in shape. Okay, it is obliquely situated, that's why it is forward in direction. You can see that it is a backward portion. Okay, or it is a little bit backside, or it is little bit forwards in direction. Okay, so that's why it is oblique in direction. So that's why we will say that the apex is basically like it is directed downwards, as this is the apex. So it is directed downwards and it is directed forwards. Okay, and the next point is, it is situated into the left fifth intercostal space. Now what is the intercostal space? First of all, we will see that, then we will discuss the remaining points. Okay, so as you know that these are two ribs. Okay, the rib 1 and the rib 2. Okay, so the space present between these two ribs, this space is called the intercostal space. So as this space is present below the first rib, so this space will be called as the first intercostal space. Okay, so just like that, we will make the six ribs and the five intercostal space. One rib, then this is the second rib, then this is the third rib, and this is the fourth rib, and this is the fifth rib, and this is the sixth rib. Okay, so this is the first intercostal space, this is the second intercostal space, this is the third intercostal space, this is the fourth intercostal space, and this is the fifth intercostal space. Now what this point is saying, that the apex is situated into the left. So as we all know that a heart is basically situated into the left portion, or the slightly deviated to the left. Okay, it is slightly into the right side and it is slightly into the left side. So because it is deviated, so apex is situated into the left side, into the fifth intercostal space. So this is the fifth intercostal space, so apex will be like directed this side, and it is situated just like this. Assume that this is the apex. Okay, so it is situated into the left, then fifth intercostal space. This is the fifth intercostal space, and 9 cm from the midline. Now what is midline? Okay, so as we all know that sternum is present. Okay, so the line that is dividing the sternum into the two equal halves, that line is called as the midline, or it is also called as the mid sternal line. Okay, because it is dividing the sternum into the two equal halves, or the midline that is dividing the whole body into the equal two equal halves, that is called as the midline. So the apex is basically situated into the left fifth intercostal space, into the left side, into the left fifth intercostal space, and it is 9 centimeter from the midline. This is the distance, is the 9 centimeter from the midline, okay, and slightly below and medial to the left nipple. Assume that the left nipple is present over here, okay, so it is slightly below and slightly medial, okay. Medial and lateral, we already discussed these things in our previous videos, so you can go and check it out, okay. Now our second paragraph is, apex is basically separated from the basically the anterior thoracic wall by the anterior part of the lung and with the help of the pleura. So as you can see that this is the side view of the heart, so and there is the anterior thoracic wall is present here. This is the sternum, okay, and some ribs are also present over here, okay, just like that. This ribs are also present over here, okay, and in front of this heart, lung is present, okay, here just like this, lung is present. So what this point is saying, that this apex, it is separated from the anterior thoracic wall. This is the anterior thoracic wall. It is separated from each other, okay, by the help of this anterior part of the left lung, because the apex is situated onto the left part, so that lung will be the left lung, okay. So these two things, the anterior thoracic wall and the apex, are separated from each other by the help of the left lung and the left pleura, okay. So these are the basic things, and we discussed the two paragraphs, so remaining paragraph we will be discussing in our later videos, inshallah. So stay tuned and stay connected. If you love the video, then please do mention your friends and like, share, comment, okay, because it gives us motivation, and so that your friends also can take advantage of it. And thanks a lot.